Hey, you guys, what's going on? It's Klaus, and thank you for tuning in to today's episode of Let's Fix That Rush, and it's our special one-hour Barch and Chill series. We do one of these about every 2 weeks, and this is the account that needs it the most. So for those of you that are new to the channel, this is my rushed account that I inherited. It's the Town Hall 10. It had a level 2 king. It did not have an archer queen, and we have made it our mission in life to make it a better account. So today what we're going to do, since it is our special 1 hour Barch and Chill, I'm going to be boosting my barracks. You guys are welcome to join me, and we're going to Barch and Chill together. That means that I will not be cutting out any of the searching. I will be just barching and chilling. Now, if you guys want to know what's going on in the base, I've got all 5 builders available right now, and the goblins that we started in the previous episode is actually still going. So the focus for today, if I switch over to the army camp, the progress base, the focus of today is to get an army camp going. Now, that's 6 million elixir. The likelihood of us getting there is very unlikely, but we will do our best. So if you want to barch and chill with me, grab your phone, grab your charger, or your iPad or your tablet or whatever it is you're using, and boost with me. I'd love for you to let me know in the comments how much loot you get, as well as your town hall level and your trophy count, your league level. And if you're not interested in watching a full hour video, which I totally understand, don't worry. Skip to the last 10 minutes, watch that part, see what we do on the base. Because the whole idea is that we are going to fix this rushed account. How do you fix a rushed account? Well, I'll discuss it a lot while we're attacking, while we're finding some loot, and obviously while I'm upgrading. So, without further ado, guys, let's grab ourselves a boosted set of barracks, guys. 30 gems, and that's all I'm gonna spend, aside from boosting the king, here we go, and the queen. So guys, I've got everything boosted. I'm gonna go back to my regular base, and now I've got an army. I've got 120 barbarians, 105 archers, because one of my army camps finally maxed out, which is awesome. And we're gonna go out and we're gonna find us some loot. And look at that, guys, a first search, and we found a base that's not too bad. And of course, our priority is still elixir, so it looks like for the most part everything's pretty evenly spread. Let's go ahead and use these barbarians, these archers, to kill this queen, because she is a booger and she'll kill you if you don't kill her first. So let's kill this queen, and yes, there we go. Awesome. Okay, so the king's kind of out. He doesn't really know what's going on. All right, so 4-finger deployment, plant the fingers and go. I don't know if there's any settings to allow that or not, but I get asked all the time how to do a 4-finger deployment. And honestly, I just plant the fingers, hold it for about half a second, and then I go for it. And if there's a setting or something that you have to enable on your tablet, because I'm using my tablet, I don't think it'll work on a phone. But if you have to enable some setting or something, I have no idea. I really have no clue. So anyway, it looks like we're gonna have some extra elixir on the south. There's a decent group of troops getting the elixir on the east side. And now it looks like we get a decent group of barbarians kind of grabbing this town hall as well. Actually, they're gonna all die. Okay, so we have to choose here. We've already grabbed, oh wow, hey, that is an, oh man, no! That was terrible. Okay, so we have to choose. Where do we want to send in our king and our queen? Now, this compartment here has 2 collectors, or a collector and a mine, and it also has a collector and mine on either side. One down here, and one down there. So I'm going to send in my king straight at that cannon. I'm going to put my queen directly behind, and hopefully we can break into this wall, and we can get all this loot. So I'm going to pop my king's special ability to help us out with getting through this wall. The queen should lock onto a significant amount of loot while he breaks in, and he's just tanking the damage while the king gets the loot. And this is how we roll, guys. So this is how we fix that rush. We are prioritizing mainly elixir because we are prioritizing stuff in our laboratory. But this episode is to show that the laboratory is not the only thing we're focusing on. We also need to get particular buildings upgraded, in which case I'm not entirely sure if we're going to actually get to do anything of significance today. We don't have a lot of loot. Really, to be honest with you, I haven't really even logged into this account since last episode. I've been super busy, but I just wanted to do this. This was what I wanted to do. So anyway, Barch and Chill, guys. The Archer Queen is kind of doing her thing. She's not not having to worry about much right now. This mortar is a problem, but we're getting a lot of the Dark Elixir out of that storage, and I'm pumping her special ability once she gets tacked on to by a point defense like a Tesla or an Archer Tower or whatever. So we'll just have to see. Oh, that? Okay. Yeah, Tesla. Thank you, Tesla, for ruining my experience. Okay, let's just get out of there because she's going to die. And that was pretty good. 320,000 gold, 358,000 elixir, 500 plus dark elixir. Not too shabby and a really good first search, actually. So I'll go ahead and speed up, train the second. And normally what I like to do is I like to have an army, a war that we can go back and look at, you know, but this one's not going yet. So I guess we're just going to have to fill in the gaps with whatever we can come up with at the time. And here's the thing also, guys, is that it is, it's only 20 seconds till the next one. Whenever you're boosted with Barch, you're generally not going to have to wait too terribly long. So I've been asked a lot of times by people, like the question, like, why am I upgrading my walls and not my defenses? Should a rushed player really force gold into traps? Things like that. We'll definitely be covering those today, but I've got an army, so let's go fire it up. I don't want to use up that second search, guys. Look at that. That's the first search 2 times in a row. That is a new record for me for sure. And the loot's decent. I mean, 300,000 gold. I'm not going to pass that up. So let's go ahead. Let's two-finger deploy the barbarians first. Just like so. Yeah, those extra 5 archers gonna do some work as well. Can you believe it? We spent 6.75 million elixir and all we benefit is an extra 5 archers per raid. It seems like it's not worth it on the surface, but it's actually not too bad. It's actually it's actually worth it in the end because every time you raid, you're benefiting from it. Just like upgrading heroes. You know, every time you raid or every time you take a defense, those heroes defend you. So it's totally worth it to spend the loot to get it. So anyway, we got some archers kind of working on that collector down there. Come on, get it all. Yes, okay. We got a good group working on the Dark Elixir drill and the archers getting it as well. So that's good as well. We got a little group of barbarians and archers going to get this Dark Elixir out of the drill. We already got all the elixir though. That is awesome. I'm wondering if we'll get all this elixir or are we going to come out short? No, wow. All right, so we got all that dark elixir. There is no point in putting our king or queen down because we've already got all the loot and I don't want to wait for them to regenerate. So let's go ahead and end the battle. That was the second first search of the video so far. And we are doing extremely well at this point. Averaging 280,000-300,000 elixir per raid. So let me go ahead and start this Barch up. And this is also one of the negative parts of finding a good first search is that now we have like 4 minutes of downtime where we're just going to have to fill in the gaps, guys. So let me go through some base explanation here. First of all, this is a base that I designed. A few days ago, I posted my Tunnel 10 base design. This is the exact same wall configuration, except for because I haven't put down my Expos or my Inferno Towers, I adjusted the walls to fill in the gaps a little bit. But overall, it's the exact same base. I need to make a few adjustments, but look, if I go into my defenses, I've got an extra bomb tower I need to build. I've got 3 Expos, actually 2 bomb towers, 3 Expos and 2 Infernos I need to still build, but the way I figure putting in extra defenses is just going to ruin my rush even worse, so I might as well kind of semi, I don't want to say engineer because that's not something I really believe in, but definitely want to continue ethically upgrading this base based upon the king and the queen's levels. So let's make that discussion. Let's have that discussion I was talking about earlier. What level should my walls be, my traps be, my defenses be? What level should my troops and my laboratory be? Well, let's assume that we're going to organize our base based on hero levels because we're always going to be pouring Dark Elixir into our king and our queen. So that means that, for instance, the level 5 king. Level 5 king is max Town Hall 7. However, I've got a level 8 queen. You don't get a queen until Town Hall 9. So that means that our base should technically look, because I've got a level 8 queen, my base should technically look like a new Town Hall 9. However, because you as a Town Hall 9 should have max Town Hall 8 walls, which are level 8 walls, we are way behind on our walls. And since walls are the easiest thing to really see our progress, I like seeing early progress whenever I'm working on these Fix That Rush series, I am prioritizing walls with my gold. Another thing is, once you get past level 8 walls, you can upgrade level 9 walls with the elixir. So I kind of feel like, you know, if we push with gold really, really hard, and we get all of our walls past level 8 or level with level 8, then once our elixir demand goes away because we finish all the elixir buildings or we finish all the elixir lab upgrades, then we'll have something to do with our elixir. And then our gold is going to just be like, what do we do with gold? Oh, well, we've got all these defenses to upgrade too. And then, of course, Dark Elixir goes into the heroes in the lab as well. So it's kind of like you got to really think, I don't want to say one-dimensionally, I don't want to say closed-mindedly, but I'm just hard-pressed prioritizing my walls first. I'm going to get them all to level 8, and then I'm going to start working on traps primarily, but defenses as well. You've seen in previous episodes as I go to my progress base, guys, that what I will do is I will put all the gold that I can into my walls, aside from using all of my builders on the cheapest upgrades, which last time was a bunch of spring traps. So as we do that, the upgrades are going to get more expensive, and the walls, we're gonna get less walls done every episode. So it's kind of a struggle because of my, I have to keep all of my builders busy. It's just how I'm wired. I can't help it. So that means that it's going to get harder and harder to finish up these walls. And we have a lot of walls. My walls on this rushed account are worse than my Town Hall 8 account for my Town Hall 8 Let's Play. In fact, I maxed my walls like 2 weeks ago on my Town Hall 8 Let's Play. So, hey, you know what? It is what it is. As long as we're working, as long as we're trying, that is what matters the most. All right. So I've got my third. Oh my goodness, guys. What's going on? A third first search. Another dead Town Hall 9. We've had 3 dead Town Hall 9s in a row. This is awesome, guys. If we can keep this up, then we're gonna be making bank, man. Seriously. All right. Well, let's spam deploy as always, guys. And of course, there's this lovely king down here. So we'll go ahead and make sure we kill him. And then I'll deploy all of my archers as well. Now, in most cases, you want to deploy your barbarians and then your archers as quickly as you can, because the archers are going to shoot over the walls and get the defenses while they're busy on the barbarians. However, we had to kind of wait. I wanted to get that king down, so we're likely going to miss out on a couple of buildings here just because of that delay between the barbarians and the archers. So we will determine the best place to drop our king and our queen to grab the rest of the loot here in just a second. Okay, so it looks like the elixir that is remaining is up here on the top left-hand side. So I'm going to put my king right here, and then my queen right behind. The queen should take out the archer tower. This is kind of like a big version of Barch. All right, so you get your barbarian in front. He is absorbing the damage. It's only level 5 king, so he doesn't last very long. But you have your queen behind, kind of shooting everything down. So watch this. The queen takes out the archer tower. Now the queen is going to help out with the wall. And now hopefully the king the king's going to absorb some damage first, pop his special ability, and just because he was dying, you know, and hopefully he can help get through the rest of that wall there. So there we go. We got that. The queen's going to work on the Tesla. I hope she gets the sweeper and then swings up and takes care of... Okay, fine. I want her to get the elixir out of that collector. So hopefully she will still do that. Let's see. Let's see what happens. She's going to get this sweeper. Look at that dead expo, guys. That is music to my ear. Where are you going? Are you serious? Are you serious right now, Queen? Betty. Come on, Betty. This is baby Betty, by the way. She's in my baby account. So baby Betty decides to get the dark elixir out of the storage. I usually am pretty happy about that. So I guess I can't complain, but now she's breaking back into the wall. Why are you so stupid? Okay, well, she's going to grab this air defense. She'll grab the X-Bow. She's probably never going to make it to that elixir collector, but because we have nothing but time, we might as well let her try, right? So she's going to get the X-Bow. I'll pop her special ability if I need to save her life. If not, actually, I don't foresee any issues coming up. Let's see if she steps out of the range of that mortar, and then I will use her special ability, because I don't want to use the special ability and lose all the archers. However, let's see. Yeah, she loses a significant amount of HP when she gets hit by that mortar. I think she's got maybe one more shot in her. Oh, there's another mortar. Okay. Popper special ability. I guess we're going to get this town hall, but we're going to miss out on the elixir that was in that collector, unfortunately. So that's not good at all. But you know what? with the queen, sometimes she she's not very smart. All right. 3, 2, come on. Yes. That was clutch. All right. So the first search in a row, guys, and we have locked onto a great amount of loot already. We've already gotten it, and a star bonus. How you doing, star bonus? Thanks, buddy. I love you. I love you very much. Anyway, so I was saying, okay. So let me give you guys the plan, because we've got how many 2 minutes. Like, let me give you guys a plan on what's to happen in the future. I know I do this every video, but I think it's important for any new viewers out there to understand the mindset of this kind of thing. So a Fix That Rush series. This was a Town Hall 10 with baby hero, level 2 king, no queen, and Town Hall 8 level troops. And so whenever you have a Town Hall 10, you are matched up against other 10s in in multiplayer. And if you get level 8 troops, you can't hit Town Hall 10s because they kill you. You can't win. So it's really hard. You guys should see it. Go back to the first episode if you can, and if you haven't already, and watch that first episode, because I'm hitting bases for like 50,000 elixir, and that was all I could find. It was awful. Now that we got some good troops, got Max Barch now and stuff, it's a lot easier to find loot. But anyway, so with the elixir, I'm going to be prioritizing dark elixir drills and army camps absolutely first. Dark elixir storage as well, not so important right now. And definitely want to get this dark spell factory upgraded, because it's going to be unlocking things like the earthquake spell, haste spell, skeleton spell, things like that, and we definitely want to get that unlocked. And then all of these dark barracks and standard barracks. The dark barracks are going to unlock, like this one would unlock the golem, this one would unlock the Bakery in half the time it takes to train those. And then these barracks, this level 9 barrack would unlock the P.E.K.K.A. And these level 10 barracks unlock the baby dragon. So really, none of these barracks upgrades are super valuable to me, because I'm just going to be barching probably for the next year. So there's no point in me upgrading the barracks. I'm going to put all my elixir into my laboratory, my dark elixir infrastructure, and my army camps. So we have our barch. I will explain the gold situation here in a moment. And looks like we got not quite as lucky as before with our search. It's an interesting base, though. I mean, look, we got all these expos are kind of dead, but the collectors and mines are empty. So it's a weird base. It's interesting, but I'm not gonna pursue that base. All right, so we're not gonna get super, super lucky. Hey, 3 first searches in a row was baller. I have to admit, it was epic. But now I guess luck is gonna catch up to us, and we're gonna actually do some searching now. So, you guys, for those of you that are new, my minimum requirement for searches is now roughly 300,000 elixir. Sometimes I go for less. Like earlier, I hit a base with 350,000 gold or something like that for looking for that much elixir. Whatever, man. I mean, I'll find and I'll take out whatever I need to take out. The point is that we take out some sort of profit. This Max Barch is going to cost us probably 85,000 elixir or something like that. And so if we're hitting bases at 300,000 a piece, we're going to be profiting about 200,000, just over 200,000. And that means that after 10 raids, which is generally what you get in a boost, you're going to profit about 2 million elixir per boost, which is pretty good. I'm not going to lie. That's not bad. But, you know, being able to take away more, like, look at this. This is a dead 10-08, 200,000 elixir. It's just not worth it to me. It's just not worth it to me to hit that, especially since it does take a little while for my troops to wake up, for my troops to train. So I'm very picky, very selective as to what I choose to attack. Here's another one that's decent. I mean, 230,000 elixir. That's my priority. I need elixir above and beyond everything else. Dark elixir is very important as well. But between the two, I have to choose the elixir for a while. And so the plan with the elixir, I can tell you this as well. We already talked about the barracks, the dark elixir drill, dark elixir storage, the army camps. But what about the laboratory? Well, we've maxed out our barbarians and archers. We've maxed out our giants, working on goblins. And I'm going to be also working on different spells. So heal spell, jump spell, etc. And so what that's going to cause is we're going to have the perfect opportunity to use some Gibarch, not just Barch, but Giants, Barbarians, and Archers. And what that does is that allows us to dive deeper into bases, and we're going to be able to get Dark Elixir better. We're going to be able to hit bases that aren't necessarily dead, because right now, Barch, we're only able to hit dead bases with loot and the collectors in the mines only. So having a stronger Gibarch is going to help a lot, but I have an army that I particularly love. I used to do it all the time on the channel. It's called Gigabarch, Giants, Barbarians, Archers, and Goblins. And that is a baller strategy. That was the best. So I'm working on those lab projects, and what I'm hoping is that whenever we're done with the elixir, which will take a while, but once we're done really having to push elixir really, really hard, we'll be able to convert to really hunting dark elixir really, really hard, and we can start using our max Gigabarch. That's the plan. That's what I'm hoping to do. But for now, we're stuck with good old-fashioned Barch, and I hope you guys are having better luck than me, because right now, I had epic loot, epic luck, and then all of a sudden, the well has run dry. Now, holy moly, 600,000 gold? What the heck, dude? Wow. You know, I'm willing to bet there really isn't a lot in the collectors in the mines. I mean, yeah, there's a little layer of pink at the bottom of this collector, but I bet it's only like 100,000. Man, I wish I was stronger. I wish I had a better queen. That would be super, super helpful. But you know what? It is what it is. That is the struggle of our rushed account. And check it out, guys. This is a super low level town hall 10. Has decent gold and elixir. I think I'm going to go ahead and hit it because I couldn't find a base. So let me go ahead and begin the deployment there. This guy has, it's a town hall 10 with a level 1 king. I don't see a queen. So this means that this is a worse rush than my account, which is completely crazy. I cannot believe that we found a base that's worse than mine. That's crazy. So yeah, all right. So the max Barch really tearing up this base. I really like the color combination of the pink and the yellow walls. I really like how it looks. I just wish it was more effective. I wish it was actually a viable strategy to have that kind of wall build. But it's just too weak, you know? It's just too weak. It doesn't do the work that I need it to do. And look at this, guys. Almost all of the splash damage in the core is out. We have a couple of wizard towers. We have a couple of mortars still. And a couple of Tez's cannons, dark elixir drill. So we're doing pretty good for ourselves. The only loot left in the base is actually that dark elixir drill. So let me go ahead and start my king and my queen on it. Because it doesn't look like we're going to get all that splash damage and take out that that town hall. So let me put that king down, my queen down, and I'll pop my king special ability. And then we're going to cut out of there because there's no point in sticking around. So decent loot. We broke that 300,000 mark, or almost did with that loot bonus. And one good thing about it is whenever you search a long time, your Barch is, if you got it like pre-cooking, like if I go in there, I got another one pre-cooking. If it takes you a while to search, you're good. You just search back to back, you raid, and then you do it again, back to back. You don't have to sit there and wait. So I guess there's a benefit to either one. However, I was talking about the gold usage on the base. So right now, we are primarily, like I said earlier, actually I covered this pretty well, covering gold mainly in walls, but pouring them into the cheaper upgrades for now. We'll be putting in the new defenses once the heroes are both level 10. So I want to put both bomb towers, and I'm going to put all three X-Bows into the base once my king and my queen are both level 10, just to help out with defense. We're not going to be upgrading those X-Bows because we do want to keep our war weight down so that eventually I can war with this account. So that's why I haven't been upgrading my heroes that's why I haven't been upgrading my defenses too much, because if you upgrade your defenses too fast, you have a lopsided base, and you automatically are a hindrance to your clan in war because your war weight is too high. So I am going to continue refraining from upgrading defenses too much, especially key defenses like X-Bows, Inferno Towers, etc. So, with all that being said, Elixir is still our priority, and Dark Elixir is obviously going to be poured right into our heroes. I'm hoping to at least put the King down to level 6 today, but it kind of depends on how much Dark Elixir we end up with. If I end up with, I probably won't, but if I end up with enough Dark Elixir to put my Queen down, That's what I'm going to do. That's almost always what I'm going to do, at least until she gets to level 10. Once my queen gets to level 10, my king will be ready to go to level 10 as well, and I won't pour dark elixir into the queen until after he hits 10. So anyway, that's the story. That is the plan. That is what's going on. A few days ago, let's change the subject now. A few days ago, I posted a video talking about having Fan Wars on the channel, and I'm really, really excited about it, guys. If you have not heard about that, go watch the video a couple of days ago. I should have attacked that one. That one was a good one. Dang it. You can, if you follow me on Twitter, and I know I push my Twitter a lot, and it might be irritating to some of you, but it is what it is. If you go follow me on Twitter, you have the ability to join my clan, one of my clans that I will be in personally, and we'll be actually doing some wars together. Klaus and the subs having a 50-50 war. It's going to be pretty epic. So go watch that video for more information, but it's pretty exciting. I'm really excited about it. So that happened. What else has happened lately? Tunnel 10.5 upgrade guide. Hope you guys are benefiting from that. For those of you that are higher level and are interested in controlling your war weight, which I've already mentioned in today's episode so far. And what else we got going on? Of course, Boston Tea Party is chilling in the CWL. I keep missing the replays because I'm a terrible YouTuber. So I was out of town this past weekend, and I'm going to be out of town again this next weekend. And because the CWL wars are friendly wars, the replays last 24 hours, and I'm almost never home to record the replays. So it's really terrible. Hey, this is not bad. I don't know how effective we'd be at breaking this base's face off, but let's try it anyway. I'm going to put my king down, start tanking some damage. I'll put the queen behind. And then let's start by putting a couple groups of barbarians and then sending in a whole bunch of barbarians once they break into the wall. Let me pop the king's special ability. Once we get into the wall, come on. All right, well, the barbarians have all been deployed. Now we have all of our archers. Let me go ahead and drop a couple of archers on the corner buildings while they do their work. And I know at this point, in this point in the video, I'm going to have a lot of people asking me, why don't you use spells? Because they would come in severe handy right now, you know what I mean? And the reason for that is simple. They cost a lot of elixir, and there's hardly ever a time when I really absolutely require using spells. I try not to spend elixir. That's why I'm using Barch. I'm trying to be cheap, you know? So that is why I have not been using my heal spell or rage spell or anything of that nature. It's because I really, I'm trying to be as cheap as I can. We're learning at a farm on the cheap. That's what we do here. So anyway, I'll pop in Queen special ability. We did pretty well for ourselves. Not great, not terrible. We'll break open that mortar there. That expo is killing my queen. No. Pop Queen special ability. There we go. We're going to get this elixir. I wonder how much elixir we had. I don't remember how much there was, but it was pretty. I wish we would have gotten that storage. That would have been nice too, but it doesn't look like we're going to get it. I'll let the queen die getting the dark elixir, and all right, let's get out of here. All right, 349,000 elixir plus a loot bonus. That is not bad. I'll take it. That's nice. And starting up the Barch again. We have 5 seconds before we can go back out and search. Very, very nice. 3, 2, 1. There we go. Awesome. All right. So what I love about the Barch and Chill episodes, guys, is for one, you guys can play along. You guys are playing. It's at a decent pace. It's not like there's raids back and forth over and over again, giving you guys false expectations. That's the main issue with YouTube, is that we always make these videos and we try to compress them so that, you know, they're not too long or whatever. But it gives people a false expectation for farming in Clash of Clans because they think that we're finding these bases that we record in, you know, in the videos after, you know, 2 seconds of searching. But the truth is, a lot of times it takes me nearly an hour to find the bases I show you guys in the videos. Just depends on how many attacks I show, etc. So when it comes to the Barch and Chill, you guys see that just like y'all, you're searching for bases forever, and so are we. So am I. So That's why I love the Bartch and Chill series. That's why, because I believe it's realistic. It's fun. You guys can hang out with me. We can talk, you know, back and forth, or at least forth, you know. And it is what it is. It's an enjoyable thing. So let me put my king down, my queen down. We'll grab this gold and cut out of here. Pop the king special ability, pop the queens, and get out of there. And nice, 300,000 elixir. Love it. And we're doing pretty well. We're on our way to getting at least a Dark Elixir Drill upgraded. 400,000, I believe. They're all level 4, so that means we're going to have, not 400,000, 4 million elixir to upgrade this baby. It's a 6-day upgrade, and then, of course, the rest of the builders will be used doing cheap gold upgrades, hopefully. And we might even get to put some in the walls today. Each wall is half a million gold, so there is that, you know, so... We'll just have to see. We'll just have to see how we do. And, of course, because we found that last base pretty quickly, we got a few minutes before this barch is, or this army of barch is ready to go. So, what have we maxed out? I think that's a good question. For those of you that have been watching this entire time from the beginning, you guys know that the walls were awful. We had like the level 5 and 6 walls, lots of pink walls. We got rid of those several episodes ago. And now, you know, we spent time maxing out our collector's mines, storages, etc. We have maxed out our spell factory. We maxed out our clan castle. We maxed out our builder's huts. I'm just kidding. They don't get upgrades, you silly folks. You're silly. You're silly, Klaus. Anyway, army camp level 8, making it rain, you know what I mean? So we have a lot of work to do left on the base, but at least we can look back and we can say, you know what? We did good. We're doing good so far. And I have to admit, being able to... Okay, so on my Town Hall 8, my Town Hall 8 Let's Play that I'm doing right now, it's actually really, really relaxing. Some people are like, why do you only barch Town Hall 8? Well, I mean, I get all the loot I need at Town Hall 8. I don't need to do anything special. And I find barch to be very relaxing. I don't find it boring like some people. Mainly because on my main account, I'm in Champion League Town Hall 10, using Quad La Lune for the farming. So it's like, you know, I, on one side, I've got like super strategic, stressful. And then on the other side, I've got something that's just relaxing and chill, you know. So again, the Barch and Chill. Barch and Chill. That's the name of the game, right? We get to chill. We get to slow it down. We get to relax. We get to hang out together. We get to watch this series. We get to get loot. And I don't have to kill myself trying to project too much. Let me ask you guys a question. It is 30 minutes into the video. First of all, if you are here watching me right now, I want you to post in the comments. I want you to post in the comments a password. And the password is Klaus Loves 30. Because we're 30 minutes into the thing. Klaus Loves 30. If you post this, then I know you watched up to this point, and I love you. You are absolutely OP, overpowered, absolutely incredible. I love you. That wasn't what I was going to say, though. I forgot what I was going to say. I lost my track of thought, guys. Oh, okay. Let me ask you this question. We got 30 seconds to spit it out. Let me know in the comments if a 2-hour episode of Barch and Chill would interest you. I know a lot of people that would probably say, no, 1 hour is long enough. 1 hour is too long. Don't bother trying to do a 2-hour Barch and Chill. But then you got those other people who are like, dude, I'll watch you for 8 hours straight. You know? I mean, I couldn't do an 8-hour Barch and Chill. I am standing while I record, you know? My feet would get tired. My voice would get tired. But... you know, there's those guys out there who do stream because their schedules are actually normal. It's a weird time of day for me, so I don't have the schedule for streaming, at least for now. You know, hopefully that changes in the near future. But some of those streams are like 4 hours long, you know? It's crazy. So, would you guys be interested in watching a 2-hour Barch and Chill instead of just a 1-hour Barch and Chill? Let me know in the comments your thoughts on that. I really do want to know what you think. This isn't just YouTubers begging for comments and activity on their channel. It's not like that at all. It is legit Oh, man, this is good stuff right here. That's a good base. I'm going to hit this base. But anyway, it's a legit question I'd like to know. Would y'all be interested in a two-hour Barch and Chill to where we boost two times, or would you rather just watch a one-hour Barch and Chill and then be done? Let me know in the comments. Anyway, so let's get this thing going. Barbarian and Archer on this bomb tower out here. I like to kill the splash damage defenses on the outside of the base whenever I can, just because if they go unattended, they can really mess up a raid. So now we got our four-fingered Barch deployment on either side. Make sure you put down our archers quickly as well. And then I will use my... let me go ahead and put my archers down. Okay, I will use my king and my queen to snipe some elixir once all this is said and done. Looks like we've already got a pretty decent amount of dark elixir, which is awesome. And now what we need to see is if there's going to be any elixir left that we need to get with our king and our queen. And it looks like we do. It's going to be right here. So let me go ahead and put down the king and the queen. And hopefully the queen can kill that arch tower quickly, and then the king can get into the base quickly. It is a pink wall, so that should help a lot. And get through the wall, buddy. Yeah, there we go. Awesome. All right, so the queen should take out the X-Bow. There are some skeleton traps doing their work over there, but king's doing good. Queen, come on, Betty. Kill that X-Bow, Betty. Betty, good job, Betty. Oh, Betty. I love her. I love Betty. Alright, so let's pop the queen's special ability. We'll take out the elixir out of that storage there, and then we'll close out because we're going to be busy on the king, and that won't be any fun. And we actually got less elixir than I expected, but still a decent amount. I'm pretty easy to please when it comes to this rushed account. I remember day one when I was mass goblin with Town Hall 8 level goblins and averaging 50,000 elixir per raid. That sucked. That was terrible. So, I'm pretty easy to please on this account. It's good. I'm glad, because otherwise I'd be hating this series. I used to actually really regret making these videos. Like making the Let's Fix That Rush series, but you guys love it. Like seriously love it. So, I you know what? Let's do it. And then I made it more fun for myself. I took the pressure off of having a whole bunch of loot at the beginning of every episode. So that's why our loot was basically empty when the episode started, in case you're wondering. Because a lot of YouTubers, what they'll do is they'll pre-drink, pre-loot, if you will, to where whenever they make the video, and I do this a lot with my regular account, and that's okay. I'm not saying it's a bad thing, but on this account, it was super stressful. So I quit doing that, and all of a sudden, the series became more fun for me to record. Which is important. You want me to be having fun, otherwise you guys wouldn't be having fun. And I love this series now. I think it's one of the most interesting series on the channel for sure. So what were we talking about earlier? I feel like we were talking about something. I don't know. Let's see. The Barbarian King, 22.5. All right, so we will definitely be able to put down the Barbarian King today unless we get, wow, 21,070 more dark elixir for the queen, 45,000 for the queen, 22,500 for the king. That is crazy. We'll definitely be putting down the king. The queen's too expensive. But hey, level 6 king, that's better than level 5, right? I mean, having a good strong king is important too. So, also one other person said, why don't you request for troops? And the answer is, Barch doesn't really require troops. I don't need to request for troops. I'd rather let my clanmates donate to other people who are doing things that are a little bit more difficult, maybe. I don't even know how I would use them. I mean, I would request for any. I'd say any. And then they'd give me giants, and now I wouldn't know what to do, you know, or they'd give me a bunch of goblins or wall breakers, you know? I don't want to deal with it. I like keeping things simple. I like the cost of 30 gems plus the heroes is 40. Boosting spells and using them would be more. And then having to remember to request between each attack. I just don't want to do it, you know? So there is my Klaus logic on that. 3, 2, 1. Bam. Yeah. All right, cool. So... we now have an army, and we're going to go out and find us another raid. Now, there have been, and I actually did this a while back on this account. I have lost the replay since, but I have run into 600,000 golden elixir, and it was all accessible with Barch. Now, that's extremely rare, guys. That is extremely rare getting stoked. It's extremely rare finding that kind of loot on a Town Hall 10 rushed account with only Barch. However, it does happen, and it really blows my mind when I find it. So I'm always hopeful that I'll find one of those in this type of video to where it can be like the highlight of the video, but I never do find one. I guess that just proves that I'm human too, huh? It's all luck based, you know? It's all luck based, and I'm not exactly lucky. I'm not going to say I'm lucky. I have been very lucky with my Town Hall 8, I'm not going to lie, but with my rushed account, my main account, nope, not lucky. I feel like I've run into the same bases over and over again. That is another thing that I've been wondering, is that do you feel like on occasion, and I know there's got to be at least one other person out there who believes this, and if you happen to be watching this right now, I want you to tell me in the comments, but have you ever felt like you're kind of cycling through the same bases over and over again? Not just the same base design or base layout, but like the exact same accounts over and over again. I mean, I used to like sit and watch the name of the accounts that I'm skipping, and I don't see the same names, but whenever I'm not paying attention to it, it seems like I'm skipping the same bases over, like every 20 bases is the same base. I don't know. It's really, really strange. Let me know if you're like that, or am I just paranoid? Because I can accept that if I am. If I am paranoid, I can accept that. I can. And my paranoia is not helping me find loot. But that's okay. Hey, you know what? We're getting to hang out regardless. So that's okay, right? It's okay. But seriously, dead base right now, like a dead Town Hall 10 with dead Infernos and Exbos. That, whoa! Oh my goodness. This is another one of those bases. I wish I was using like Lunian or something, but I'm not. I'm using Barch because it's cheap and efficient. Sometimes too cheap and too efficient is not worth it, by the way. You get what you pay for. That's a deep, deep life subject right there. You get what you pay for. Don't forget that. All right, so here's a base. The defenses are too strong. 474,000 elixir I had to skip. That's terrible. Oh, and by the way, last 1 hour Barch and Chill, everyone was freaking out because I missed a base or whatever. I mean, think about what I'm doing. I'm recording for an hour, all right? That's already impressive enough. I'm talking nonstop throughout an hour. The likelihood of me making a mistake and accidentally skipping something I don't notice is pretty high. I mean, how often do you accidentally skip stuff? So if I miss something, don't freak out. I mean, I'm human too. I'm just a man. It's okay. I promise. All right, so the loot is getting grabbed right now. And it looks like we got all the elixir. So I guess now we need to prioritize dark elixir. And it looks like the easiest dark elixir will be coming from the northwest. All right, so the king is down. Oh man, the queen's gonna get targeted by that Tesla. That's terrible. All right, well, I'm gonna have to use my queen special ability early unless she just wipes out this Tesla early too. Come on, Betty. Oh wow, yeah, that was awesome. All right, so let's see, is the queen gonna come around and hang out with the king? Yes, thank you, Betty. You're not so dumb. I mean, you are dumb, but you're not like so dumb. Let's pop a king special ability. Let's poison the enemy queen. Hopefully the Arc Queen can come over and help out with that. That poison spell didn't do jack. That was terrible. All right, well, the Queen's going to work on this storage, and then I hope she will come around. She'll work on this storage, and get this Dark Elixir. And we'll pop the Queen's special ability at one point, and we'll grab more loot, and we'll get fat, and we'll get happy. And then we'll go home, and we'll take a nap. And it's going to be glorious. So the queen is now working on, I don't know, whoa, special ability. Wow. Okay. Well, we missed the dark elixir, but the queen almost died without me even realizing it. That was insane. And again, the elixir, not quite 300,000. But you know what? We will take what we can get, and I'm happy for it. So Anyway, Bartsch is training up. We got about 20 seconds left to go. How many minutes? We got 18 minutes left in our boost. We are doing good. I hope you're doing fantastic in your boost. I hope that if you are rushed base, that your rushed recovery is going well, going better than mine, to be honest with you, because there is nothing I can do about it. I literally have to just work hard to get through it. And I'm willing, but it's a struggle. So anyway, my army is ready. So let's go out and find another base. And looks like, I mean, look at this base. We got 383,000 elixir. And most of the loot is actually accessible by archers. Look at this. This elixir storage is right next to the outer wall. And then over here, this one is two. And so is this one. So let's do this. Let's do a two-finger deployment on either side of the base, on the top right and the bottom left, just like this. Just like so. Alright, so the Barbarians and the Archers are max level, so that means that they should be able to handle themselves decently as they deal with the defenses. Next step is, we want our troops to grab the loot, and it looks like this Kalan Castle is kind of ruining our Barbarian spread there, so we're gonna miss out on this elixir. What about over here? Archers are doing work. And we got one of the elixir storages. So, you know what? I think I tried to do something like this last episode where I tried my best to get, like, stronger defenses, and I just couldn't do it. So, anyway, pop the king special ability quickly so that he can start working on that wall quickly. Queen is working on the cannon. Queen is working on the archer tower. King walks up. He's going to help out with the archer tower. That is awesome. Queen is going to grab this elixir out of the elixir storage. King is working on the other elixir storage. This is why good heroes is good, by the way, because they grab loot when you can't, when you suck and you miss out. And the queen is outside the range of other defenses, so she is making the bank happen right now, and I'm not going to complain whatsoever. We're going to grab the dark elixir. Where's the other dark elixir, by the way? Just curious. Oh, there's one up here. Okay, well, we missed out on that. Pop the queen's special ability. We're going to kill that sweeper. Hopefully, no, there's no way we're going to get 50%. The special ability for the queen doesn't last long enough. Let's go ahead and close out. And 264,000 elixir. Not great, again, but not terrible. Not too shabby. We did lose the raid, but I don't even care about trophies at all with this account. I just don't want to drop below Gold League. If you drop below Gold League as a Town Hall 10, you will hate your life. Unless you end up down in, like, below Bronze. If you're down below Bronze League, it is like a whole new world down there, you know? If you've ever been down there, you understand what I mean. But the problem is, whenever you take a defense, you end up like middle of Silver League all of a sudden. It's crazy because you get hit by so many people dropping that it's impossible to stay down there. That's the problem with it. But on a lighter note, our troops are growing. They're getting it done, and we got just about 2 days before this goblin is done. So what I'm gonna have to do, and I'm pretty sure you guys won't mind this, is in a couple of days I'll post another Let's Fix That Rush video. Not sure, probably unlikely that I will post a 1 hour Bartsch and Chill episode. I'll likely just do a lot of farming before, show some massive loot, and then start the next lab upgrade. Let me know in the comments what you think about that idea. If you want me to do another hour or 2 hour Bartsch and Chill, let me know. We've already discussed all that, but we will definitely be putting down the goblins again if there is another upgrade for the goblins. I honestly have no idea. The lab plan is we're going to get the wall breakers eventually, but they're not a top priority. We're definitely going to get the healing spell maxed out. We're definitely going to jump spell level 2 and 3. That'll make a huge difference. And, that was it. Okay, sweet. So, jump spell, healing spell, and wall breakers, and obviously maxing out our goblins. And that's gonna wrap up our Gigabarch. I mean, we're going to be able to wreck everything with that. It's going to be pretty epic. And then, of course, upgrading our king and our queen every day. Ugh, so much work to be done. There is 50 hero levels for Town Hall 9. It's insane. It's ridiculous. There's only 5 for Town Hall 8. There's only 20 for Town Hall 10. There's only 10 for Town Hall 11. Why in the world is Town Hall 9 so huge? I don't even know. But my king and my queen are way behind because of that. My king is Town Hall 7 level. I need to get him to level 8, Town Hall 8 level, maximum level 10, before I can even consider myself a Town Hall 9. But I'm really a Town Hall 10. It's crazy. I should upgrade. I should click this 7 million gold upgrade and go to Town Hall 11 just to ruin everything. I'm just kidding. That would be awful. That would be terrible. Definitely not going to do that. Anyway, so 23 seconds to go before our barge is ready. And, my phone was not even on silent. So that is a scary, terrible thing to do. Because, you know, I've had this happen before where I'm recording something important and then I get a phone call I have to answer. It's awful. So, anyway, Wizard Tower level 2. That is crazy, man. That is crazy. This account still surprises me. Like, whenever I first saw it, it was like, why? But now it's like, wow. You know, it is still terrible and it still surprised me. Here is a first search, dead 10 all 10 with 300,000 elixir, and I'm going to take it because 300,000 I have discovered today is kind of rare. So let's go ahead and spread these barbarians and archers out. We got some baby heroes. This town hall 10 is worse rush than us. Level 2 king, level 1 queen, and of course this level 1 queen is hiding behind the wall. So she's cheating right now, but everybody else seems to be doing just fine for themselves. Here is a very nice juicy level max level elixir collector. We're gonna grab all that elixir out of there, and we're not even gonna need to use our heroes this time. Look at all this. Look at all that, guys. We got a huge group of troops just breaking into the base. And if we could use our king and our queen to take out the mortar on this bottom right hand side, we will be in the clear. So let me go ahead and put this down. The king is in. Yes, there we go. All the splash damage is down. We got a ton of troops still. We're going to 3-star this base, guys. This is also why being rushed is bad, because if you end up taking defenses nonstop, you're going to get 3-starred nonstop, and it's just an awful experience getting 3-starred by Barch. You know, you should not get 3-starred by Barch. So Yeti, 47, please upgrade your base, brother. Actually, no, don't do that, because I got loot from your base. So, I mean, I shouldn't be complaining. I should be thanking you. I appreciate it. I know that sounded super sarcastic, but, you know, it is what it is. I was being sarcastic, but I wasn't trying to be mean about it. I was just trying to prove a point that rushing a base is not a good plan. We got 11 minutes of boost left. That means I've got 5 minutes before this barch is ready to go. That means we got maybe two or three armies left. And let me check my treasury. Ooh, 500,000 elixir. That is awesome. So we will definitely have enough elixir to put down a dark elixir drill. We're nowhere near 6.75 million elixir for this army camp. So we'll definitely have to try to, farm up enough elixir eventually. It is still very difficult to max out my elixir storages, so I don't feel so bad that I didn't do it this episode, or most episodes, to be honest with you. But we will be starting a dark elixir drill, because free dark elixir, hello, that's a good thing, we want that. And so that's one builder. We're gonna upgrade the Barbarian King. That's two builders. We're gonna have three builders to spend with gold. So that's 5, 6, 7. What is that? 1.8 million gold. That means that we need to save 1.8 million gold and we need to use the rest on our walls. So 1.8, 2.8. If we can get to 3.8 million gold right now, then we'll be able to do a few walls. So hopefully. Oh, and the 500,000 gold in the treasury. So that's going to help as well. 500,000 gold per wall. And I've got, let me see, if I edit and remove all, I've got 254 walls. That means that's 127 million gold. It's a lot of gold. Wow. Oh, man. I don't want to feel depressed, but man, that really did bum me out just a minute ago. That really did bum me out. Actually, you know, another thing is we need to upgrade these air defenses. Town Hall 10 air defenses are super valuable on your base, defense-wise. So, I might choose to upgrade this air defense. I'm not sure yet. I've got a few minutes left before my rating is over, before I have to make that decision. Making decisions! It's okay. It's okay, Klaus. Relax. Relax, man. You're gonna be fine. 2 minutes to go. It's been a good day, though. I mean, let's just face it. It has been a fantastic day. At least for me, it has. And I want to, again, remind you guys to follow me on Twitter so you can be a part of the movement for the fan wars. You can war with Klaus. It's a big deal. I'm really excited about it. And I'm also obviously trying to bring more of my the Klaus family, my subscribers, to the Twitter, because it's another way for you guys to contact me and for ways for me to contact you. So I'm really trying to pull y'all in, guys. I am trying to convert you from whatever it is you do to the Twitter. That's one of my plans. I'm going to be straight up with you, be honest with you. That's what I'm trying to do. Anyway, so 15 seconds left until this Barch army is going to be done. 8 minutes left in our boost. We're doing pretty good for ourselves, I would say. I mean, over 3 million elixir, I think. It's not bad. And if we can find two more good raids, you know, if we find two good half million elixir raids, that's another million. That's awesome. That's what we want. So Barch is done. Let's go out and find us another couple of dead bases. And of course, the goal is always to be, to be flexible. So I sound like I'm focusing only on elixir. Wow, look at that, guys. 600,000 gold. That is crazy. Gold League loot is insane, guys. I had to skip it because this army would get pooped on. But that's a decent base too, but not good enough. Gold League loot is decent. It's good. But you just have to have better armies. Again, I can't afford it right now. Spending more to make less. I'm not interested. Searching for a base. This is probably the worst part of the whole experience, is sitting here trying to find a base, searching through bases, looking at loot that I could get if I wasn't so much of a weenie. Yeah, I said it. Weenie. Yep, rushed account. I feel like I'm a weenie just because I have it. But hey, you know what? Recovering the base has been one heck of an experience, and I've enjoyed it. So I don't feel terrible. I really don't. I just like to make it sound bad because then I get sympathy. I'm just messing around, guys. Just messing around. Oh, man. Come on. We need to find two good raids back to back or we're not going to make it. 258,000 elixir. No! 500,000, but it was all in the storages. Ugh. Come on. Ugh. I mean, yeah, it's great loot down here, but I can't get it because it's not, like, collector and mine loot. I may want to consider it. So, again, I'm thinking about it. You know, I really want to maybe upgrade my balloons, maybe upgrade my lava hounds. Actually, I have to unlock lava hounds first. yeah, so I'm thinking, man, I really should. Whoa! Whoa. Wow. Guys, whoa. We're gonna smash this base so hard it's gonna wake up next week. All right, let's do this. Let's put down the king on the X-bow there, and let's drop our barbarians. The king special ability, there we go. We'll send in our barbarians on either side to make a double entry point, just like this. There we go. And then we will use our archers and do some work there. As long as our archers get in without dying, we should be able to get all of that elixir from the collectors in the mines, guys. So look at the loot. It's going to be flooding in, guys. And they're making a funnel on this bottom side. So the queen should actually go into the core. We got our barbarians on this far side working. We got a big group. Wow, we got a huge group of barbarians in the core, guys. And a bunch of archers. I think that we're going to be just fine. I'm feeling good, guys. I am feeling fan-freaking-tastic. We missed that collector. Crap. All right, well, maybe we'll 3-star. There's no telling, right? There's no telling what's going to happen. This bomb tower is really doing some work right now. Dude, really? Would you stop it? Quit it. Are you seriously still doing that to me? Okay, well, Papa Queen's special ability. It looks like we're going to miss out on some of the elixir and some of the gold, mostly because of this jerk. And our queen got trolled by the enemy queen. So Unfortunately, it looks like we are definitely going to miss out on a lot of gold. We did get a lot of the elixir. We got all the dark elixir the base had to offer, and we missed out on a single collector because I'm dumb and I didn't hold any troops back. So, you know what? Still 449,000 elixir, 1,600 dark elixir. I love that. I love it. How many times have you guys heard me say that? I'll get loot, and I'm like, I love that. That's sick, man. That was awesome. Yeah, that's the enthusiasm speaking, right? So, 4 million elixir now without the treasury. So that means we got 4.5 million elixir. We're going to have 500,000 left over at least. Gold, we're going to have about 4.2 million unless we find more later. And we need 1.8, right, for our defenses and stuff. You know what? Let's go. No, I'm not going to do it out of order. I don't need to do it for my own curiosity. I was going to say, let's go ahead and put down those three defenses, but I'm going to wait and hold my horses until the end of the episode. All right, so the boost only has 2 minutes left to go. We got 36 seconds before our barch is ready, and then we can go out and find another raid. And let's go ahead and request for a poison. Somebody might give me troops as well. I don't really care either way. So we got our Dark Elixir drills working. They're level 4, max level is level 6. Getting these all maxed out would be fantastic because it would be 100. Yeah, this is doing 60. 100 per hour is actually the maximum for Dark Elixir drills. So we could be bringing in 300 Dark Elixir per hour. That would be 3,000 every 10 hours, 6,000 every 20 hours, and then 300 times 4 is 1,200, so that's 7,200 Dark Elixir per hour if these Dark Elixir drills are maxed. That would be really helpful. Did I say per hour? 7,200 Dark Elixir per day. And if I actually was smart enough to log on to the account and actually get all that every single time, we wouldn't have as much of an issue. But I'm not that good. I'm just not that good. I'm trying to get better, though. I'm trying. But I'm not good. I'm dumb. I go days and days without logging into the account, and then whenever I log into it, it's dead. It's like completely dead. King and queen are like starving to death. Like, bro, you haven't been here to bring food. We called you a week ago. I would like to find one more of those bases we just hit. 500,000 elixir would be nice. But I can't say with any certainty whatsoever if we're going to run into anything even close. That was definitely the best loot of the day so far. But of course, let's not forget the best luck was those first searches. The first three attacks of the video all being first searches. That was really awesome. I'm never that lucky. I'm lucky. Again, I'll say it. I am lucky sometimes. But I'm never that lucky. So, anyway. Gold League farming, guys. It is interesting to do, but it's hit or miss for sure. It's either gonna be plague. No. Feast or famine. There we go. No plague. Feast or famine. Wow, 500,000 elixir, and it's a lot of it in the storages. Ah, come on. Keep finding these monster loot grabs, and I can't actually grab it. It's out of my grasp. It's all right. I'm sure you guys that are watching and barching with me, or whatever you're doing, you know, if you don't have to be barching, you can do whatever you want. I'm sure those of you out there that are doing it with me are having better luck than I am. And I hope you are, to be honest with you. But we're not having a terrible day. I don't want to say that as in making it sound like we're having a terrible day. I mean, in one boost, getting over 3 million elixir is fantastic. But it's just, you know, high standards. I can boost with my Town Hall 8 because he's not rushed, because he can hit any Town Hall 8 he wants. I'm able to max out my elixir collector or max out my elixir storages with a single boost. 6 million golden elixir with a single boost. And look at this, guys. This is a defenseless engineered account without a... Oh, well, the queen's here. I just thought that was interesting. That's an interesting looking base. And eventually we'll find a base worth hitting. But I'm not complaining. Shut up, Klaus. Quit your complaining. It's all good. You're going to be fine. You're not going to die if you don't find loot immediately. You can be patient. You know? You are not entitled to loot. You have to work for it, just like everybody else. So let's find it. keep skipping these terrible bases with, like, you know, 30,000 elixir, it makes you wonder, like, are we ever going to get the ability to, you know, change the parameters of our search? That'd be an interesting thing. For instance, right now, I would have changed the parameter to 300,000 elixir minimum. That way, I'm in the clouds more. I don't have to spend my gold searching until a base with at least 300,000 elixir pops up. It would only show you what you want, which would be interesting because I bet people will just sit there and search for 1 million elixir all the time. That would be interesting, wouldn't it? I doubt it'll ever happen. Whoa, 500. Did you see that 500,000 elixir? A lot of it was in the storages, though. That's why I skipped it, but dang. I hope this is showing you guys that loot's still in Gold League. I don't care what Town Hall level you are. There's a lot of loot, like, in Gold League and in Crystal League, too. I haven't been up there at all, I don't think, with this account, but Crystal League's pretty solid. I'm starting to get impatient. I really want to get this last raid done. But I don't want to... Whoa! Okay, there we go. Yeah, alright, 400,000 gold. I am grateful. Thank you, Clash of Clans. Thank you, Supercell. Thank you. Alright, so Barbarian's down, Archer's down. Next, a level 2 Archer Queen defending her corner. Just got destroyed, so that was nice. I've got my King and my Queen. Hopefully we can use them to grab some loot, unless we don't need to. I like that. I like when we don't really need the King and the Queen to do anything. We'll just have to see what we end up with once the Barbarians and Archers are done. All the elixir is out, all the gold is out, now the dark elixir from this little drill is all that's left, so I'll go ahead and drop my King and my Queen, pop their abilities, grab that dark elixir, and close out. There we go. Wow, 400,000 elixir. That one is the second best one, and they're both at the end of the video, so very, very nicely done. Do we have time? Wow, Velcro Face with the Valkyries. Whoa, nice. Velcro Face is a stud, by the way. He's been at Knights of Zion forever, but anyway, so that is it for my boost. It is over. It's going to take 15 minutes for the next Barch army. I'm not going to sit and wait for that, so it is time to spend some loot. If you're just now tuning in because you skipped all the raids, you missed out on a lot, I recommend you go back and watch whenever you get a chance, but if you don't, I understand. However, I did recommend people to follow me on Twitter because of the Fan Wars videos that are going to be coming out, fan clans that I'm going to be opening up and I'm going to be warring with. I also, I had some awesome raids at the beginning and at the end of the video, but there was good ones in the middle as well. Now it's time to spend our loot. Now, normally the first thing I do is focus on laboratory, but it is busy, so let's upgrade a dark elixir drill first. It's 4 million elixir, and that will cement our elixir that we need to spend in this video. The next thing I'd like to focus is our gold. We got 4.1 million gold. I will go ahead and collect. That's 500,000 in our treasury, so that's 4.6 million gold. And for examples or explanation of what I'm upgrading and why, if you are just tuning in, I explained it all in the video, so you can go back and listen if you'd like. But I'm going to do the cheapest 3 gold upgrades. So we get a spring trap there, so that's a 16-hour upgrade for 500,000. Skeleton trap, that's 600,000 for 6-hour upgrade. Wow. And a wizard tower, level 2, going to level 3. It's a 2-day upgrade, 700,000 gold. And now I've got one builder remaining for my dark elixir, but I'm going to pour the rest of my gold into my walls. So that's 2.5 million gold. That is 5 walls. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Pull out that wall there and select all, guys. So 2.5 million gold going into walls right now. I remember when I first started and 2.5 million walls took forever to get. It's still really slow, but it's a lot better than it was. So gold is now done and we are broke. Now the last thing to focus on, guys, is this Barbarian King going to level 6. That is a 2.5-day upgrade, 22,500 dark elixir in 3, 2, 1. Bam. Boost is over, so no interruptions there. And that is going to do it for today's Barch and Chill episode and our Let's Fix That Rush episode. I think it's like episode 13 or something. I'm not entirely sure. But guys, be sure and like this video if you liked it, and subscribe if you have not joined the Klaus family. And also, I asked a very important question during the video. I'll ask it again. If you would like to see longer Barch and Chill episodes, maybe a 2-hour Barch and Chill episode, let me know in the comments as well. But anyway, guys, that is going to be it for me. I love each and every one of you. Thank you for tuning in, and I will see you guys again next time.